The study of the environment is something that we have all become extremely comfortable with and accustomed to in recent years. Without such a great group of professors and motivated students, this learning we have experienced would not be possible. So many people in America, let alone the rest of the world, do not have the opportunity we are grasping right now to learn about the interactions going on around them. These everyday actions that individuals take are what determine the future of our race, our society, our countries, and most importantly, our children. Without education, there can be no hope that the billions of youth throughout the world will ever have the knowledge to recognize the impact they each have. I see a future where environmental education takes precedent over all other forms like history, math, and English. Why? Because we are living on the brink of destruction and the consequences are immediate. In the late 19th century, indeed, three different kinds of environmental problems became matters of public debate. One problem was the prospect that the nation would soon run out of the vital resources, especially wood. To ensure that future generations would have adequate supplies of essential raw materials, many people joined the conservation movement, a phrase that became popular in the first decade of the 20th century. Second issue was the fate of the wilderness. A number of organizations began to argue that undeveloped lands and great natural beauty ought to be preserved. The third problem to attract attention before 1900 was pollution, a horrible threat to health in the nation's fast-growing cities. That threat led to far-reaching efforts to improve the urban environment. Historians agree that three developments after World War II encouraged the rise of the modern environmental movement. As the economy boomed, newly affluent Americans became less willing to accept environmental degradation as a price of progress. New technologies from the atomic bomb to chemical pesticides brought new environmental hazards. The popularization of ecological ideas also gave countless citizens a new appreciation of the risks transforming and manipulating nature. Environmental activists have taken leaps and bounds to get us where we are today. They did so for people like us, to encourage us to fight against the powers that are destroying nature at an astonishing pace. They did so for people like us to spread the available knowledge, for people like us to have the ability to make a change. Like all movements, the environmental activism needed to save our future is one of the masses. Like Otto Leopold, we all need to start thinking like mountains, recognize that for every action there's a reaction, and most of the time it is necessary to understand reactions before actions are taken. Thank you. Bye.